Education is the product, then the teacher is the producer, charged with the incredible task to prepare the next generation to be active, engaged, and productive citizens in the global community.
It's probably going to take you about 10 minutes to go through each document, discuss with your group, each individual document, and then how they collectively get together under All Men Are Created Equal.
Folsom Cordova teachers come from a variety of professional backgrounds, but the common thread that binds them together is their passion for helping students succeed.
I love working with kids. They give me energy every day.
This is my 12th year teaching in the district, and it's been really the best 12 years of my life.
I've always been passionate about teaching. I love what I do. Been doing it over 30 years and still feel like I'm brand new.
We talk about really important things, really interesting things. So it's always about the students, always.
There is no such thing as a typical day for a teacher.
The only thing typical about my day is I usually get here when it's dark and I leave in the dark with a big bag full of work.
It's difficult to say there's a true typical day because you're working with young people. They come with different moods, different things, different feelings, experiences. So every day is extremely different.
There really is no typical day. As a teacher, my schedule stays the same each day. Besides that, I'm doing different things with my classes.
You never really know what to expect. You know, you have your whole day planned out. You know what your lesson plans are. And you walk into the classroom and it can completely change and you just have to roll with it.
You can have all of your lesson plans ready to go, but then comes the scraped knee that needs the triage, or someone's feelings are hurt and you have to call a quick community meeting and make some resolutions, or even the shoelace that won't come untied needs your expertise.
But what makes it exciting is to work with them and being able to adjust to the unexpected.
Our teachers take their work home with them and are constantly seeking ways to improve instruction.
All of these teachers, we all come together constantly. We share resources, we share materials. We do a lot of the same things together, our professional development outside of school.
Folsom Cordova teachers are committed to professional development.
There's a really good chance that teachers get outdated more quickly now because you have to keep up. You have to go to professional development. You have to be aware of where these kids are and what they're doing.
Within our district, we have our own professional development, which we've created, which I'm very appreciative of and have been a part of.
Well, as a lead teacher, our role is to support teachers in curriculum and instruction. And we also offer professional development.
What I love about Folsom Cordova is that because we have a really good professional development academy, we're sort of a step ahead as far as the pedagogy all of the time.
You know, they're trying to be innovative. They go to a lot of workshops on their own time.
Many of our teachers have advanced degrees, and Folsom Cordova has the highest number of National Board certified teachers in the Sacramento region.
Well, one thing that I think sets us apart from other districts is we have a lot of teachers that go for National Board certification, which is like an advanced degree, but it's something that provides a lot of professional development for the teacher, and it's above and beyond what's really expected.
Okay, National Board is a rigorous progress that teachers can go through.
It's a big process. There's many different steps to it. Teachers can do it in a year. It's usually a 2 to 4 year process.
It is a certification that you can obtain. It's the highest that you can obtain as a teacher. And even though it's extremely rigorous with all the researching and the planning, the implementing and the reflecting, it's worth every minute that you've spent on it.
They're really passionate about the students and about their teaching. They're constantly going above and beyond to really make a difference in the classroom.
Many of our teachers are active participants in the lives of their students, both inside and outside of the classroom.
I like visiting, going to the softball games. I've gone to basketball games for my students. Current students and former students will come and invite me to their sports events.
Our teachers are amazing. They are very dedicated. They're very student-centered. They work hard to get to know their students.
I really think it's important to make connections with kids.
I've been to football games. I've been to ballet recitals. And this year, my student who invited me to her ballet recital, I've promised Isabel that I will be at her ballet recital. And every morning she'd say, "I can't wait to see you at my ballet recital, Miss Hawkins, on Friday." She would remind me every day, which showed me how important it was to her.
Our parents truly appreciate the investment that teachers have made in the lives of their children.
For my student, Isabel, she's given her the confidence to just be able to believe she can do anything. She was very happy that Miss Hawkins was able to take time out of her busy life to come and see her perform.
She just shows them how to have so much respect for every individual.
She can keep them all focused and, you know, really listen.
And I really wish that I would have had someone like her when I was in school.
Teachers often have commitments outside of the classroom, like being a club advisor or the coach of a team.
This club that I'm doing is a Black Culture Club, but it's open to all students, all backgrounds. We talk about doing good deeds for people and not expecting things in return. And the students make scrolls and they share, they write down every good deed that they do. These are things that I don't do beyond pay. I'm not paid for these clubs. I've been running them for about 12 years now.
Teachers don't do it for the money. They do it for the reward of knowing that they are changing the lives of young people. What you may not know is that many teachers have to sacrifice personally in order to make a difference in the lives of their students, but they do it in a heartbeat.
It's definitely always a balance because one day I was late to the pumpkin patch to go pick out pumpkins with my daughter, and that can be hard sometimes.
I do about 10 other things other than what I do in the classroom on different boards and so forth. And I've missed some of my kids at athletic events. I used to coach and things of that nature. Sometimes you make a sacrifice of your own family for your other family, which is the students and the staff here at Mitchell.
To me, that shows students that you really care, that you would take your personal time and come and spend some time with them.
Even better than that is when the students start coming back after you've had them. They come back and they want to be your TA, or you get that graduation announcement, or you get an invitation to your graduation party.
Teachers are personally invested in ensuring that their students have all that they need to be successful in the classroom. Most of our teachers simply can't pass up the school supply aisle when they are out shopping.
Almost every time I go shopping, there's something in my basket for my class, and I'm sure that's with most educators.
There is not the funding support.
We're stretched thin. We are.
We really don't have budgets for supplies and things. We rely heavily on industry to support Project Lead the Way and other programs at our schools.
There's sometimes when I have to dip into my own pocket.
The first year was $2,300 that I spent on top of, out of my own pocket, on things for my classroom.
In the classroom years ago, as a new teacher, we were allocated like $250, $300 for materials. A lot of that funding is gone now.
For years, education has suffered budget cuts, and the effects on our teachers have been significant.
So we're continually asking them to do more when programs are cut.
There are a lot of burdens on the teachers that we face.
We're up to a lot of kids in the classroom, and it's hard, and I feel like we wear multiple hats now. You know, helping with library and helping with attendance things, and there's things that we're doing now that we've never had to do before.
I mean, they have more students, they have more standards that they need to cover.
We feel pulled and stretched thin. I can't be a counselor for 37 children in every class period sitting in my room. There has to be other resources. So things like counselors that have fallen off, really important, school nurses, just administrative help.
Some of our teachers have had the honor of being recognized by their peers, earning the coveted title of Teacher of the Year.
I have been blessed with being chosen Site Teacher of the Year 3 times.
Having a nomination is incredibly special. Everybody that I've worked with always works very, very hard. It is not just me, it's a village. We work together.
I stand up and I look around at all the amazing educators that are out there, and they're cheering for me. I mean, these were my mentors. These are the people that inspired me. So to be chosen to represent them, it's very humbling and such an honor.
Folsom Cordova teachers are committed to using some of the highest quality teaching methods to engage their students.
I see our teachers doing things that other teachers or other districts aren't quite doing yet. I see a lot of inquiry-based classrooms and project-based learning.
My classroom is absolutely discussion-based, and it's a really high-energy sort of environment in my classroom.
We understand that kids need to have both the skills and the critical thinking.
But I see that they build upon the students' strengths and their interests.
You have to be a little bit more entertaining in terms of keeping their attention because they're so fast-paced. You know, everything is just instant.
The students have done everything from aerospace engineering. We launched rockets and built wings. Disney Channel came out and filmed an alternative energy city that my students built. Last year we had a space simulator, so in the classroom that you're in now, you can see the classroom behind me, this was the space station, and the classroom next to me was mission control.
Our API scores continue to rise because teachers spend an enormous amount of time reflecting on their practice, looking back at data,
and saying, you know, what can we do differently? How can I target a certain group of students?
Students today are technologically fused, and our teachers recognize that they have to modify traditional teaching methods.
You have to look at how technology is going to be in the classroom, and that's something that I've always been interested in technology, but when you think about the future, it's all going to involve technology. With the rise of online education and online colleges, online learning in our district.
And I think we need to teach them to use technology ethically, morally, intellectually.
And so students need to get the skills in the classroom, and the teacher has to be able to provide those skills.
We have teachers who do blog with their students. It's a way that the students can respond to different discussion or writing prompts. And then we also have teachers who are doing the flipped classroom.
I have every day 53 minutes, and flipping the classroom says what's the best way to use that 53 minutes. So normally in a normal math class, the students practice with their homework at home, and with the use of technology now, I can post videos online. So a student can go home, they can pause it whenever they need to, if they don't understand something, they can rewind it and watch it again. We have discussion boards online where students can post questions and that other students can respond to them that night. I can respond to them that night so that they are working through that and learning a concept at home.
We have so many different programs that foster different strengths.
Programs like Project Lead the Way are designed to prepare students for the highly technical careers of the 21st century.
So Project Lead the Way, and oftentimes referred to as PLTW, it's been around about 20 years. It introduces students to engineering. Our district is really considered to be the flagship district for the state of California for Project Lead the Way. And it's a great hands-on program so that students who are college-bound will get some real common sense experience. Everything is on the computer, the learning tools. We go through simulations on the computer also. As an example, in our flight and space, we use several NASA simulations of both airfoils, how to build an airplane wing that will actually create lift. I really stress with them, this is based a lot of math and science, but we are going to show it to you in a different way. You're going to put your hands on the project, you're going to develop it, you're going to test it, you're going to modify it, you're going to make it better, you're going to take control of it like we want you to do with your own life and make it work the way you want it to.
But this is a single circuit, I can push it. If I break that loop anywhere, the light goes off.
There are many myths about the profession that our teachers were happy to debunk.
Well, even though as an educator we have contracted hours, it doesn't come close to the hours that are spent.
I do not go home at 3:30 and just forget about my classroom.
Many teachers I know are working 10 to 12 hour days and they're still taking work home with them.
You know, so a lot of the paper grading and the lesson planning happens at home.
There are some Sundays where I'll sit down and spend 10 hours just on grading, and I haven't even gotten to my lesson planning yet.
I don't think people realize how much of the nights and weekends are taken up.
And then over the summer, a lot of our teachers either teach summer school or maybe get another second job over the summer.
Being a teacher is a time commitment. It's not like any other job, and everybody thinks, oh, you got your summers off, it's easy. That is not the case.
I kind of thought that when I first started teaching, like, look, I'm gonna have my summers off. I haven't had a summer off ever.
It's not just a job that you go to and leave. It really is like a lifestyle.
They think that teachers go into teaching because they can't do anything else, which is not true at all, because we have so many teachers with advanced degrees, but they chose to be a teacher because that's where their passion was.
Our teachers love their career, and many offer advice to students who are considering entering the profession.
Those who think about going into teaching need to be really flexible and just be able to go with the flow and enjoy it.
I would say look into the areas where there's a lot of growth, as an example, math, science, technology. Look at career trends and industry trends.
If you're passionate about what you're doing, just hang in there, because eventually some people will retire. I don't know when that'll be for me, but eventually some people will transfer out or retire and an opportunity will open up.
Teaching is not a job, it's a lifestyle. You have to be willing to give your life.
I think they really need to know that it's hard. And that may dissuade some people, but I think that's okay, because it's so hard that you don't want people who aren't ready for that to get in.
I think you have to be called to it almost. I don't think everybody can be a teacher. It's almost like an art form to be a really good teacher.
And I can certainly tell someone, if you want to get more than just a paycheck, this is the best profession you could ever choose.
Our teachers are the engine of our success, and their dedication and passion make all of the difference to our kids.
the one thing that keeps me moving forward are my students. I mean, I want to give them my best every day, and that's what motivates me.
It's a very challenging job and a challenging climate and environment, but it's so rewarding.
I was planning on 5 years in the classroom. Now this is my fifth year, and maybe it'll be 10 or 15 more years in the classroom. I enjoy it much more than I thought I ever would.
It's tough, but it is so rewarding. There's nothing I'd rather be doing. We are emotionally vested in this school because a lot of us live in the area, and a lot of us really want the schools to be where we'd want to send our own children.
Everybody knows kids have to go to school, but it doesn't have to be a boring place. It could be a fun place. It could be a happy place, and that's what I try to do.
When my kids are out of the house, away in college, which we're just about there, I have 175 of my own kids right here I get to see every day. So it keeps you young, keeps you energized, and it really puts a lot of meaning in your life.